Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute and just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air.
Hi guys, welcome back. It's Gina. And we're gonna go ahead and get right into this video. I don't wanna waste any time. So I want to do a video, well, of course I want to do a video, that's why I'm here. I want to do a look for bangs. So I've been rocking this wig and you guys are going to see it at the end of the video. But this is one of the first wigs that I ever purchased. So I've had this wig, I want to say every bit of maybe 15 years, give or take some. So, and she still looks good and she's still my favorite. Her name is Tina, and it always reminds me of the Tina, the singer. So anyway, let's go ahead and get into this video. So that's what inspired me to do this look. We're gonna go ahead and get started by priming our lid, and I'm gonna use MAC, the painterly, no, this is the soft ochre. So I'm gonna use this and just place it all over my lids. And just a bit into that above my crease. All right, now we have that all blended in. The next thing I'm gonna do is take some powder, and I wanna use some translucent powder actually. So I'm gonna use some Benai, and I just wasted it all over my table. But anyway, we're just gonna go ahead and go in and set that. There we go, nothing fancy. And nothing hard about that. Now I'm gonna go ahead and work in my Jaclyn Hill palette, and I am going to use, I'm gonna start with this transition color first, just to see what kind of payoff I get with that. And I'm just taking 224 brush. Just kind of go in there. That's a nice color payoff. All right, now that we have that color laid down, I'm gonna go into something a little bit darker and I'm gonna go into the one right next to that and place this on as well. And I'm gonna use a more tapered brush. All right, this one is a bit fluffy, but I think it'll give me just what I need. So let's take that color. And I'm just gonna bring that color all over into the end of my eye. These colors are so easy to blend. I absolutely love it. So now I'm gonna go back in with that first brush and just kind of blend and soften that area. All right, so let's do this then. Let's go back to what I know works. I'm gonna go back to the Jaclyn Hill palette. And shoot, it's gonna make me change my whole look. Well, guys. All right, let's do this. I'm gonna take that color, that second color, and I'm gonna put that all over the lid. Let me see. All right, so that'll work. Let's get this other eye done, since now we know what we're doing over here. All right, guys, I kind of like that. So we're gonna go ahead and get that liner put on. And I'm gonna go in first with, this is the Infallible Black Buster. So let's take care of that. All right, we'll do that with that one. And then I'm gonna take the NYC high definition eyeliner. This one is smaller, so it's gonna allow me to get a nice crisp line on the outside. Now, you can do this step that way, or you can do it this way. And then go back with the bigger pen. Next, a tight line, at least attempt to. All right, now we're gonna do the mascara. The lashes I'm gonna use today, guys, is from Kiss, and I'm using the Lash Couture. These are Faux Mink. This is from their Faux Mink collection, and this is number 67750, if that is the code for it. But these are Midnight is the name that's on there. So I'm gonna go ahead and put these on off camera, and I will be right back. Okay, so for foundation today, we're gonna use Maybelline, and this is Better Than Skin, and it's a Super Stay foundation. I am not sure if it's going to give me a matte finish or not, but this is in color Coconut, so we're going to see how this is going to apply. Next, we're gonna go ahead and do some highlighting and some contouring. And for contouring, I think I'm gonna do some cream contouring. So I'm gonna use Espresso from the LA collection, LA Pro Conceal collection. And see how that will work. Don't really need to do the forehead because we got bangs today. And I'm just gonna use the other end of the Beauty Blender, or the My Beauty Blender. And of course, to set it, I'm gonna go in with my CoverGirl and set that out. For highlighting, I'm gonna use this CoverProof foundation, and it's a super light foundation for my skin tone. So we're gonna use that, and I'm gonna apply this with a brush, just a eyeshadow brush. See the difference? Oh, yes, I like it. Take some banana powder, and I'm mixing the banana powder and the topaz together. And I'm just gonna highlight those areas. Now, while that's baking a bit, we're gonna go back and work that lash line. So we're gonna go back into the Jaclyn Hill palette, and I'm gonna take that color and place that underneath. So I'm gonna go with that first color here and use that to blend everything together. And I'm using a smaller tapered brush to do that. Then I'm just gonna go right in my waterline with the black and just brush everything away. And I'm gonna use this setting powder to marry everything together. Alright guys, it is now time for the lippy. I have everything else together, kinda sorta. We still gonna do some things with the eyes, but I wanna kinda go ahead and get this lippy on. And I am using Jordana, and this is Current Jam is the color of it. So let's get it. But you are so fly, you are so nice, and you are so shy. Shady girl curves that is so killing. And anytime you come around, you know I catch feelings. Man, shady fly guy. From the bottom to the top, man, she fly guy. Alright, so while that's setting, because I gotta put another coat on. Matter of fact, let me see. Alright, now we can go ahead and work on the eyes. Shimmer. And I am going to take let's go with this color for the teared up area. Now, do some blush, and I'm using Black Radiance for my blush today. Now, I'm just going to go back in with buffer brush and just get everything. And then highlight and my favorite, Melanie. Y'all know I love this. Y'all gonna highlight. Things that I really wanna get, you find you good and you really really set, and I got all the cash so I really wanna spend. Stand up on the wall, make a chitty chitty bang, and on you girl I will play some of that anyway. And then once more fly in a desk, look down girl, let me break it down from town to town, and they ask around for the baddest girl that hold it down, then they point to you, say that you hold the crown. Things now we are ready to do our hair. Slow down, girl, do slow motion. Skin smooth, use good lotion. Body so hot, I take caution. In the club, girl, you be casting commotion. Alright, guys, so don't make me hold it. Cause my love is bigger than the ocean. Wine it, girl, we just really can't wait. What to have a taste? You're the one and only girl that can cure my Chris. And this is synthetic hair, guys. So whatever hell they used back then, to last all these years, this was one of the first wigs I did when I came to YouTube. Super pretty. And I did do some alterations to her since I've had her, of course. All right, guys, so this is it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. This is just, you know, my rendition of how you can do your makeup when you have bangs and still have everything shown. The only thing that's kind of hidden are my eyebrows, but you can see the makeup and everything else. Now with this unit, you can pull it back if you want to go for this look, right? And that way your brows are showing, you can show your fleek in your eyebrows, or you can go ahead and pull it down and have that, you know, Nicki Minaj type feel on your wig, and that way you still have just a hint of your makeup showing, your inner tear duct area is popping. And then of course you can just kind of put it right in the middle, which is the way I like it, this way. But yeah, this is, I like it a lot. So come on with me to modelization time so you guys can see that as well. I'll see you over there.
Fairy lights burn into my bones, blurry nights reach into my soul. Like a fever, I can feel you taking all the control. Stumbling, tripping on the sky, you and I, sipping on the night.